Welcome to this practice update. I'm Dr. Farzana Hafizullah. Joining me today is Dr. Roger Stoop. Dr. Stoop is professor of neurological surgery and neurology and oncology at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine and co-director of the Brain Tumor Institute. He is also associate director for strategic initiatives at the Robert H. Lurie Comprehensive Cancer Center of Northwestern University. We're thrilled to have you back, Dr. Stoop.
Pleasure to be back.
Excellent. So I want to talk about the recent negative trial of nivolumab in recurrent glioblastoma. What do you think the role of immune checkpoint inhibition will be in the future for treating GBM?
So despite the fact that this trial has not given us the results we would all have wished for, yes, I think immune therapy is there to stay. Now it's up to us to really make sense how to incorporate that.
Of course.
And probably it was a little bit too naive to think by simple checkpoint inhibition we can really have that much of an impact and probably also a durable impact. Now, in combination with new approaches, also what we do at the Northwestern Brain Tumor Institute, in combination with replicating adenoviruses, there may be a role for checkpoint inhibition. There are also projects.
Yes.
We are planning in combination checkpoint inhibition and CTLA-4 inhibition. So IPI and nivolumab,
yes,
in combination is not off the table.
I see.
And probably moving things in a different setting. So
sure,
there is potential.
Okay. Negative data is certainly still important. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Do you think there is promise in the upfront setting, and particularly those undergoing concurrent radiation?
So the mechanism of action in the upfront setting is entirely different, and there could be,
sure,
a good rationale to combine it with radiation in the first line setting. Now, there are two CheckMate trials ongoing. I don't know what the result will be. There are two trials, one in methylated and one MGMT unmethylated tumors.
Yes.
About a year from now, I would guess we'll have first results.
Of course.
And we'll see further.
Okay, excellent. Now, you have led the development of TTFields for glioblastoma, and I see that there is data on this technology in patients with brain mets from non-small cell lung cancer. Can you review this data and any other data presented at ASCO on TTFields in this arena?
So on brain metastases, there's no data. What has been presented here is the concept of an ongoing clinical trial, a randomized phase 3 trial, looking at Tumor Treating Fields in patients with non-small cell lung cancer.
Yes.
Then there is trial data presented on Tumor Treating Fields in ovarian cancer,
yes,
and in pancreatic cancer. Uh-huh. And it shows that it is feasible. It can be combined. And actually, there's a lot of interest to combine with a taxane.
Mm-hmm.
And these are still two diseases where we need better local and local regional control.
Absolutely.
So there is promise.
Yes.
From uncontrolled phase 2 data, it's hard to make a story to say what is promising, because I have not a control arm. These are heavily pretreated patients. But the data, as much as I can read them, look at least encouraging enough to pursue in a next step, in a next phase of trials.
Absolutely. Now, how might the data on immunotherapy and other agents presented at ASCO, this year's ASCO, impact your decision to use Tumor Treating Fields?
I think the data for Tumor Treating Fields is clear in glioblastoma. We have shown the final results at AACR a few months ago. We have also shown that quality of life is not negatively impacted. It was one,
yes,
of the criticisms coming up when we add Tumor Treating Fields. So actually the patients do well, and as progression-free survival is prolonged, they do well longer. So here we have a modality that prolongs overall survival and progression-free survival and does not negatively,
yes,
impact quality of life.
Excellent. So it's working in synergy without adding, yeah, extra toxicity.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
Excellent. Now, prior work has also demonstrated that patients with low-grade glioma who have been treated with multiple cycles of temozolomide and other alkylating agents can develop a hypermutated tumor genotype. Do you think these people may be good candidates for immune checkpoint inhibition? And if so, how would you define hypermutated?
So, indeed, after treatment,
yes,
treatment induces mutations. So
of
it's
course,
no surprise that you have a hypermutated,
yes,
phenotype. Now, what is hypermutated and what is very hypermutated, I think clinical experience will tell us in the future.
Okay.
So that's probably one rationale you may want to use immunotherapy in a broad sense, larger in or later.
Yes.
This is probably the reason why you want to use immunotherapy later in the disease course rather than earlier.
Sure.
At the same time, we know from other trials that if you want to have impact, it was the early treatment that had impact.
Yes.
And if we take ipilimumab in melanoma, it was in the adjuvant setting that it had actually an effect. And that's probably where you're going to gain most. So I would not say just because of that in the later stage, maybe even concurrent. That's where this comes. And so it's curious to see what's the data with nivolumab in the early setting.
Yes.
It's just too early to tell.
Okay.
And probably life is never as simple as we think it is.
That's always
the
case.
There seem to be subgroups who benefit.
Yes.
But it's up to us now to identify who are the ones who benefit. But it should probably be in addition to standard treatment and not instead.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for sharing your expertise and clinical background. We so appreciate having you here on Practice Update and sharing with our viewership this vital information.
Pleasure to be here. Thanks again.
You're very Bye-bye. Welcome. And to our Practice Update viewership, thank you for joining us. I'm Dr. Farzana Hafizullah. Please join us again soon.